Dr Adeleye Jasper Olusayero created an Ajayi for himself. The family of Mr. and Mrs. Ajayi, Jasper Olusayero, received the gift of a promising and fulfilling son about 4 decades ago, and his name is Dr. Adeleye Jasper Olusayero.
Appreciation.
In 1966, we moved to the Hausa, open just almost 53 years. We moved to Nichos. We married in here. Me and my wife, we married in 1970. In 1970, I be Oma Mefa. Let you get number 4, ni Ama Mefa. Obiyen number 1 Taye number 2 Ido number 3 Leye Dr. Leye Jasper number 4
Jasper, as is fondly called, is a native of Idanre in Ondo State of Nigeria. He schooled in Jos Plateau State, where he had his primary education, secondary education, and tertiary education. He's married to Dr. Mrs. Olusayero, and he has God-fearing children.
My name is Adeleye Olusayero Jasper. I'm born in the family of 6 to the royal family of Idanre. My parents had us 6. We have the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, which I'm the 4th. We have the 5th and the 6th. We're 6 in the family. I went to a primary school in Jos, secondary school also in Jos, university in Jos. I did my postgraduate diploma in University of Nasarawa, and also my master's is in view.
Dr. Adeleye Jasper started his working career with a mortgage institution before he decided to be on his own as a private entrepreneur. From birth, Dr. Jasper has been a child who is seen to be caring and passionate about human development.
This is one of the professions that if you go through the bill, you discover is that like it has more kind of a self-employed in it. You can be an entrepreneur in this same job. But if you go through all the world, if you go through some Europe, you go through America, London, and other places, there's no how you find out the professionals that are called mortgage brokers. We have some expertise that are there that practice the same thing that which we will be practicing in Nigeria.
He demonstrated his passion for humanity when he established an NGO that is centered on humanity. He has in the past and now organized a medical outreach to take care of the less privileged who are sick, both in the northern and southern part of Nigeria.
Really, actually, I believe that some of the things I've been doing them for a long time. I've been part of community building, and I believe you get from the community and you get back to the society. And you find out from since I was growing up, as a little boy, I always believed to see how I can develop my community, where I am, where I stay. For example, I have some other projects that we have in places like Benue. I have some projects in Plateau State, some villages, interior villages that people don't even know in Plateau that actually some projects were there. And I think it is better to come home and to do something for my people because actually I have passion for my great people of Idanre. And these are the things that prompted me to bring some things to the community. Doing something for community, something have to inspire someone to do something for community. And in this, I think I've seen how life itself is short, but the things you do and what you do to show in this little part of life is what really tell about you. Like, for example, I've got to see when I was growing up, streets that have been named that people I don't know. And I believe with this, we could do something for the community or for people and put out some things that are good.
He lived most of his life in Jos and has affected the area positively in terms of providing basic infrastructure such as borehole, water, roads, among others, to the area. He decided to come to his father's land some years back because either east or west, as they say, is the best. Since he has come home, Dr. Jasper has facilitated gigantic projects to Idanre, his hometown, among which are the motorized boreholes at Okialafia Street, Oluwogbade Quarters, Yaba Idanre, another one at Prince Aderemi Street behind Olofin Police Station, Idanre. Jasper also facilitated the tarring of Ojota Market Road to Tanimao Church project ongoing.
I started raising myself that this community needs a good infrastructure, trying to see how we could bring road, water. And when I was growing up, there's no water in my house, in my village, where I mean my Olussyero's family's house. There's no water because my place is full of beautiful rocks. So you have to drill for a long time to get water. And I built up my mind, I said, when I grow up, I wanted to see, I make road and I bring infrastructure to my town. And I remember my grandmother saying something to me and she gave me a name, Ulo Tulueshe. And that was the name my grandmother was calling me as I was a little boy that grew up till she passed on in Benue, which we've also done some projects there. So these are projects that we'll be doing while I've been there. I was doing this in the north. I have passion for things I do. I started up on a program in Plateau, which is Ray of Hope, to do an HIV and AIDS. At the time, the HIV and AIDS were reigning in some town, and I saw a lot of younger generation were having HIV, and I felt it is good for us to enlighten the society about giving them information about HIV and AIDS. So I brought up an idea that there's still hope for the youth, and I started up Ray of Hope, and we did a program, we did testing, we tried to make them to know their viral load, talk about HIV and AIDS. And after we did that, I did some other community things like community service, maybe football game for our people. Then with time, God was able to give me ideas and to able bless me with some people, key friends around me, that were able to do some things like bringing water project to Plateau State. I was able to see there's a place in Vodni. Vodni has a water issue. They don't have motorized water borehole there. And I was able to look at the place and I took water there. There's a place, it's called Yumtuk. Yumtuk is quite a little far away from the town of Mangu Town, which I also took water there for my people. And inside the Mangu Town itself, when you're on your way going to Panshin, by the left, I have another water there that I've done. After doing some of all these beautiful things in this town, I felt, based on some of the discussion I've had with my grandmother a long time ago when I was growing up as a child, and I felt this should be one of the things I should come back home to do. My grandmother just called me Olu Tulueshe. Why won't I come back home to do some things for my community? And I felt, okay, we have some little challenges in my town. We need to see how we can bring some infrastructure. And they said, in my mind, I came back home and I started doing some community service. By the grace of God, God was able to give me the enablement through some key people in which I know they're able to bring water for us in our town, which they brought 5 motorized boreholes to the local government. There was a road that was there, and we were able to bring medical outreach also for our people in Idanre to see how they can actually benefit from what God has used part to bless me, which.
It is noteworthy that Dr. Jasper Adeleye is not an elected officer yet, nor a political appointee at any level, but his passion for development had really engineered him to work on his network to help his community.
Thanks to God that has given me the privilege. By the grace of God, I'm multilingual. I speak Hausa, Yoruba, Igbo, and English, and Idanre. These are my language, and these are things that can open door for you in wherever you go. There are people that when you understand their language, they feel free to talk to you and to have a conversation with you freely. And God has given me that ear that I could speak and I could talk and I could speak in their languages that they all understand. And that has really been a lot of things close to me that I was able to bring some projects down to my place by using some of my friend that is from Benue, Honorable Adamu Entono, who was in the National Assembly, which by the grace of God were able to bring some projects like the water project. You know, when you have a friend that you could talk to, based on the passion that I have for my village, and every time he's doing his consistency project, I always talk to him that I need some things in my village, and anytime I talk to him about it, he always do it for me. And God, by his grace, some of the people we have there, like so a lot of people ask me, how were you able to do a personal bill in National Assembly? Though I didn't want it maybe as a personal thing, we were able to do them through my friend, Honorable Bagos. And the speaker of the National Assembly, in the person of Honorable Idris Maji, which also helped us, who is also from Plateau State, and was able to give us a good free hand for us to do the bill, and the bill passed through first and second reading and even passed through the lower house. Yeah, I have a bill which is called the Bill to Establish an Institute of Mortgage Brokers and Lenders of Nigeria, which by the grace of God, the bill has passed through the first, second and third reading, has passed through the lower house, and which is waiting for Senate for concurrence. Few months ago, by December 15, it was read at the Senate, which we're waiting for President Buhari to assent to the bill, which is the same bill that we're bringing back to Idanre here to establish the institute in Idanre by the grace of God.
The community people could not hide their appreciation to Jasper as Pa Akinyemi of Oke Alafia Street, Olowo Gbade Idanre, Mrs. Wemimo Aroloye JP Barracks Road behind Olofin Police Station, Mr. Francis and other citizens attested to his good deeds.
Adupe lowo ogbeni Jasper na adupe gidigidigidi gudugudu meji ati aya mefa ti won ti awon na pe awon adupo na ade awo fi sile na to tun ba je kan lara omo bibi wa ko se fun baba a o ni fi le bayi.
I don't know what I'm food, but I'm a record in what Adeleye Jasper Olusayero. I'm a big leader, you're more better than you want. You won't go be Kali. For one year, the boy, we do what? Oh, what do? I go come what go on to one what? Let it be near when the river basin. So I'm our commission here. Enjoy any big boy, do what I'm big. I welcome my dad. I want to see you. Awon baba gege bi agbadugbo atawon mi gbogbo apowopo ase
doctor leye n gba to kokko wa si ida to ku awon doctors wa dtl ni esegbeke o de assemble awon eyan kabiyesi ma npa payan o de ko opodopo ogun wa e da awon doctors dtl awon tare oja o won sa emi ji mo nsoro yi gan oni bi to dun mi ngba yen ati gba yen gan pe won de dupe lowo jesu o mi sa awon to ku gan lobirin lagba do made nu won ko se de ki to tun pada do pe ohun lo kemeje pe ori fo ohun otutu pa lati gba yen ope ni fun jesu emi gan ra mi mo lo yo yo be mo tun dupe lowo jesu pe ogun yen pelu alafia ogun ati olohun ondo omisa igba yen o ati igba yen to ba ti de ba ki o pe igba ti baba ba de to ti de mami ko ma pe mi o pe ki doctor ba ti de o ko pe mi pe awon iyawo mi gan the same thing o try o mo de yen try let me tell you ni gbogbo awon ida ise to de do ma se tan o ba won olohun ni je ka bi da because the boy is trying his best as at now
adupe lowo daddy wa Jasper to ba wa se omi asiko gba tan se omi a ro mi pon ohun o ran wa lowo a ri pon ta ba ti de be ba ma ri pon adupe lowo won
adupe lowo baba wa Jasper Adeleye won ba wa se ona adupo wa ni oja ojota ni ona ta ni mo wo adupe lowo won e ola ma kuku won o ola de ma ran won lowo
we really appreciate nkan ti honorable Jasper to se fun wa ni bi baye I dey appreciate e gan lati bi odun melo kan seyin tan ti ba wa se omi won adupe lowo won ni adupo de do se gomi e bi o ko je wa niya bi o mi se je wa niya ladugbe gbata de ti gbe wa adupe pe gbogbo e o nlo ni rowo rese a de dupe pe olorun a ma ran won lowo den a de tun dupe fun ona ti won ba wa nse ni ilu ido lati ojota ni ojojota se ona ta ni mo wo ati be lo olorun a tubo ma ran wa lowo a ma gbe won soke bi to ti muwo na ni oruko jesu agba na ni wo be adupe o olorun tun ti won se
Mr. Ajayi Jasper Olusayero, the father of Dr. Jasper, confirmed the grace of God on Jasper from birth. Jasper Adeleye has been a loving child, a caring person from his childhood, he says.
But not he can really like that. Active somebody. No, mama, she had a very stubborn boy, but nevertheless, oh. That you can't get it. You just feel July. Let it bounce here. And you're back July by a batch here. I want you back to July with batch here. Titty, you'll reach cool, don't you? Everything to daddy. Very stubborn boy, very good. She died on my dad. So, he bought a tool to develop this. She died a little tall couple. Then, in fact, I tried to catch you see the outside. He's just. But he bought it better. She's a bad one. And God so kind, I told her, what to say, I have fair. I'm a deputy governor, Plateu State, don't then, or vice chancellor of University of Justice, tell her, the governor. And he, but as at now, in the year 2022, he's still the deputy governor of Plateau State, don't then. So, Omar in beer, doctor in Yaya, medical doctor. You know, I want a doctor. Only project you have here that you can more than 10 years, then you have here, you can develop interest, you can develop school can in Abuja. He has spent millions of naira every project here.
One of Dr. Jasper's aide, Mr. Tokwe Makojola, reiterated the commitment of Dr. Jasper Adeleye to sociocultural development, explained the importance of the private bill that is sponsored by Dr. Adeleye on Mortgage Institute in Nigeria. This bill that is awaiting the presidency's assent has the potential of creating over 5,000 jobs for Nigerian youths, and the headquarters is going to be in Idanre.
Shortly after we visited Idanre, about 3 years ago, we saw some projects around the police station at Olofin, close to Baba Adere Misas, and I saw his name. So I called his attention. Is this not your name? He said, yes. So how did this come by? I said, I facilitated this project, a motorized borehole. Wow, he said he did a lot, not even just that, that he also has it around St. Michael, along the former chairman of Idanre, the Honorable Kowo. Oh, that interests me to ask him more. What have you done? He said, well, do you remember there's a project around the popular Ojota market, opposite the popularly known what do we call this man that is into cocoa business, that links Basic. He also facilitated that project, so he facilitated that same project. And I thought of it that if an Idanre son or an Idanre son has done this much, so we now thought of it, like, okay, this is very good for the people. Let's find a way to do more. I haven't had the privilege to do this, not being an honorable member, neither being a public office holder. If he's privileged by the people giving him the mandate to become the member representing the federal constituency, he's going to do much, much more. Look at it on the other side, not being a public servant, neither a sitting member of House of Representatives. He has a private bill. The private bill is the bill on mortgage regulation in Nigeria, the first of its kind. This bill is going to impact youths by bringing not less than 5,000 direct jobs. I mean direct jobs. This will not only impact Idanre, the entire of Ondo State. We witness a growth.
Dr. Adeleye is now aspiring to contest for the position of Member House of Representatives, Idanre, Ifedore Federal Constituency. He says if given the grace to represent his people, the difference will be clear.
My people have been calling me that yes, we want you to come out and serve us. And if I could do this job, how about when I get there, then I'll be able to do more for them. And sincerely, I'm really enjoying my traveling every time I come home. I don't see it as a challenge. I see it as if people could call me and said, come home, we'll have a meeting with you, want to meet with you, want to talk to you. I see it as a privilege, but not a challenge. Because if people don't like you, they won't talk to you. When people talk to you, people asking you, how do you want to achieve this? How do you go about this? How do you do this? Making me to understand that they also have passion for the community. Those who are thirsty for the community are there, and they are trying to see how we could put value to the community. And with that, I see it as something that is really welcome. My traveling is not a challenge to me. And I believe by the grace of God, thank God for my friends around me that they've been supporting one way or the other and putting money together, putting things and putting value to this cause. At least I'm really grateful to God that we've already had a headway, and I believe God will see us through. My name is Adeleye Jasper Olusayero, married to the family of Teodien in Plateau State, married to Laura Jasper, who is my wife, and God has blessed us with 4 children. I have 2 boys and 2 girls, and all of us are Idanre. We are all in Idanre here, and I'm aspiring to come out for House of Rep of the Federal Constituency of Idanre and Ifedore Federal Constituency, which by the grace of God, if I'm being elected into this office, we'll do well for our constituency. We'll bring road, medical infrastructure, water, some of the things that are challenges to us here. By the grace of God, we'll bring it to us and we'll have adequate things that other people have in their community. Thank you and God bless you.
Appreciation.
Adelanke Akimoladun, reporting for Platinum Television. We'll be right back.